हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज के एम वरप्रसाद, एचओडी सीएससी डीबीएसआईटी कावली. ओके, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कसिंग द सब्जेक्ट आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड वी आर इन द यूनिट 4 दैट इज अनसर्टेनिटी. ओके, इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द व्हाट आर द बेसिक थिंग्स इन प्रोबेबिलिटीज, uncertainty and probabilities. Now coming to this one, probabilistic reasoning. Today's topic is probabilistic reasoning. In that probabilistic reasoning, we are discussing about the Bayesian networks and inferences in Bayesian networks. And coming to the next topic is temporary models, and then finally HMM, that is hidden Markov models. Here in this one, initially we are discussing about the Bayesian networks. What is actually the Bayesian network means? It is a data structure which is used to represent the conditional probabilities as well as probability independence. It is also used to represent the domain knowledge. By using this domain knowledge, we can easily provide the inferences compared to the propositional logic as well as first order logic. In this one, it is a DAG, directed acyclic graph. It is a graph, DAG. It is also called as DAG. Here the set of nodes are set of random variables. Those random variables provide some set of probabilities. For example, X arrow Y means, X tends to Y means, X is the parent which is having some probability and completely having some influence on Y. X tends to Y means, X is a parent which is having the influence on Y. Here also we are representing the independence. For example, if you are taking a weather and some toothache problems like cavity and something, weather does not affect the toothaches, does not provide any toothaches, and in this example the weather is the independent variable or independence. This is the probability independence. Now coming to the examples of the Bayesian networks, the following two diagrams shows the examples.
Okay, here in this diagram, it is a very simple Bayesian network in which weather is the independent of remaining three variables. Here comes to this one, this is the parent of these two. These two are not affected each other, but this is the parent of these two. Here toothache either comes from cavities or catch is also from the cavity. Now this is completely independent variable. Now this is a very 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 important example. Here one Bulgari alarm is set. What is actually the Bulgari alarm means? Whenever the thief come to the home, it will wake up the people. At the same time, the neighbors are there and it will get the alarm. Some disturbances also comes from some people are coming from one place to another place, a helicopter is coming from one place to another place, the so on things. Here some neighbors are also there, John as well as Mary. This is the Bayesian networks which shows the Bulgari alarm. Here for alarm, Bulgari, or whenever the thief comes, the alarm is alerted. Whenever the earthquake is there, it is also the alarm is activated. Here whenever the alarm comes, the neighbors also activated. Whenever the people which forgot this one, the neighbors are activated from the algorithm. Now this is about the very very good example for the Bayesian network purpose. Now coming to the inferences of the Bayesian networks, here the probability of x1 to xn is equal to the sum of or sigma of the probabilities of xi. The evidence is parents of this one, and parents of the set of nodes will provide the evidence to the present node. By using this one, we can specify the conditional probabilities as well as independence, probability independence. So here comes the Gaussian distribution, which is especially used for the random variables of continuous random variables. Here one child has the Gaussian distribution whose mean and as well as the standard mean is varying and the standard deviation is fixed. These are the two equations which are especially used for the Gaussian distribution, whenever the Bayesian networks are used for the continuous random variables. This is the another inference, that is the exact inference in the Bayesian networks. Here some set of query variables are provided, and then some set of evidence variables are also available. Now from some set of hidden variables are there, those hidden variables we are going to find. Yeah, this is the equation which is used for this one. X is equal to X union E union Y. Here Y is the set of hidden variables. Now coming to the next topic, that is temporal models. Here what is actually a temporal model is, in this one the time is the very important constraint, comes to the statistical distribution as well as the probabilistic distribution. Here every time or every state is a time. From that, some set of random variables are there and some set of values are there. These are all calculated to the sum as a 1. In this one the stationary process is also there, as well as Markov assumptions are also we are using. Stationary as well as dynamic things we are performing by using the temporary models. In this one some set of unbounded variables are also there. Those unbounded variables are maintained and managed by using the stationary process. And coming to the second one, some set of infinite number of parents. This problem is solved by the Markov assumption. Here the current state depends on only a finite history of the previous states. Processes satisfying this assumption were first studied by the Russian statistician Markov, which is called the Markov process or Markov chains. These are very important in the temporal models. Now here comes the diagram. A Bayesian network structure corresponding to a first order Markov process. Here one state, this is a time, some time here, and then next state, and then next state, and this one. And coming to the B, here a second order Markov process. In this one two states are modified at the same time. Here we see this one, the mark is there here, and from this one we are preparing this one. This is about the standard Markov states or Markov series.
Okay, coming to the final topic in this one, that is hidden Markov models. It is also called as HMM. In this one the set of things or set of processes are performed by using a discrete random variable. Here one process is a discrete random variable. Here the discrete random variable contains some set of values. Every set of value is a one state in a world. In this one, by specifying some set of matrices, we are going to calculate the posterior or conditional probabilities all independent variables of the probabilities. This is a very, very important topic in the examination point of also. Now, the following diagram shows the matrix representation of the hidden Markov model.
Here, it is the matrix which represents the subset of probabilities. Here, some additional state variables are also added to the temporal model while staying within the HMM framework. This matrix shows here the transition of the Markov process by using one state to the another state.
Okay, in this video we completed unit 4, that is uncertainty, taking the decisions by using the sum set of uncertainty. Here uncertainty comes from laziness and some practical ignorance and theoretical ignorance, all the things. These are provided by using the probabilistic notations or probabilistic theories. Here the probability provides the set of beliefs. Here in this one we discussed about the how we are representing the conditional probabilities and how we are representing the independence. Bayesian network is a very good tool, or it is a data structure which represents the probabilities of conditional as well as independence. Now coming to the stationary as well as time being processes or continuous processes. For continuous process we are using the Gaussian distribution for the random variables. And finally, hidden Markov models are there. Those models are used to how the probability is changing and how we are estimating the next state by using the previous state or previous set of parents information. Now this is about the uncertainty based concept. Here this is solved by using the probabilistic notations. Here comes the lockdown, stay home and stay safe. See the videos and provide some likes also. Thank you.